Why is it that we would rather accept a negative history than a positive history? I came to this because in my African American history class, I see tons of African Americans asking the professor, how do you know this is true? How do you know that Africans were the first mathematicians? How do you know that Africans were the first astronomers? How do you know that Africans were the first people to write? How do you know that Africans totally created the seven liberal arts? How do you know that Africans are the true creators of the Holy Trinity? How do you know all this, professor? Why? Teach me. Make me know beyond a reasonable doubt. But when somebody force-fed you lies and bullshit, you took that in and swallowed it like it was a sugar pill. So I question, what's going on with us? Why is it that when someone tells us something fucked up about ourselves, we want to take that in, we want to eat that up, we want to gobble that up, we want to hold that in, we want to take that in for who we are? But when someone tells us something positive, when someone gives us a positive fact about who we are, something that tells us why we are kings, why we are queens, why we should walk around with our heads held high, why we should act as royalty, why we should never let anyone tear us down, including ourselves, we don't want to accept that. So there's a few reasons for the reason we don't want to accept a positive fact about ourselves. One may be that we know that if we accepted the power that we had, we would have to act like powerful people. The second may be is that we've actually been taught to hate ourselves. So when we hear knowledge that's positive about ourselves, we don't want to hear that. That's too foreign to us. That doesn't fit into the mind frame that as an African American, I ain't shit, and that I have to live a hard life, and that I'm worthless, and that someone doesn't like me or subjugate me. So instead of hearing that history that's true for us and taking it in and using it for what it's worth, we would rather accept a lie that doesn't even make sense. We would rather accept that a statue with a broken nose really has nothing to do with the fact that someone tried to erase our history. We would rather just accept that that's what happened and that we were conquered by another group of people. All of this doesn't make any sense. Why is it that black people feel as though we don't want to accept positive facts about ourselves? What does that say? What does that say about our self-esteem? What does that say about your self-esteem? Even if you're not black, if you're another color, what does it mean that when someone says something fucked up about you, you would rather accept the fucked up thing than take it in and say, oh, you know what? I'd rather accept the positive things about myself. I'd rather accept the positive attributes about myself, the things that I've done that do mean something, that are esteemable, that will make me a better person. What does that say about you, who you are? Gucci Mane has a song out right now on his new album, and in it he says, if you hating on me, what does your self-esteem look like? If you are hating on someone else, or if you are hating on yourself, what does your self-esteem look like? And that really just says that if you practice any type of hate, any type of negativity, any type of low energy, it speaks to who you are. It doesn't speak to who I am. So when we are taking things in, learning about who we are, it's important to understand that if we really felt good about ourselves, if we really felt like I always say, if you feel like you're the flyest, the baddest, the coolest, the smartest, the hardest, the realest, whatever it is you feel about yourself, if you are so high up, right, if you are someone who is so amazing, why is it that you don't see that amazement in other people? Because if you're amazing, you know other people are amazing. Why is it that when someone says something to you that validates who you are as an African king or queen on this planet, that you don't want to gobble that up? Why is it that we gobble up bullshit, gobble up lies, gobble up things that are meant to tear us down, tear our communities down, tear our children down, tear our relationships down? Yet when someone says something to us like black family has always been strong, that for years and years and years, for dynasties and dynasties and dynasties, we have known not only how to take care of each other, but to have strong institutions. We want to question that 10,000 times. We want to find a reason why it is that black families aren't strong. Find a reason why it is that we don't have any institutions. It's bullshit. See, and what you'll do is you'll spend a lot of time looking for a lie and truth. To validate the fact that you don't feel good about yourself. Because if we feel good about ourselves, we want to not only take care of ourselves, push ourselves to a higher level, but we believe the things that validate us feeling good about ourselves. So as a young black woman, I just want to say to all of my African brothers and sisters, every single one of you, and that means every human being on this earth, that when someone tells you about the history of the African man, and it is so amazing, and it is so glorious, and it is so powerful, it is true. Take that in. Take that in as a part of your armor, a part of your shield, a part of your foundation. Because we come from a great people. All people come from a great people. All people have come from the history of the African man. So when you hear about the African woman, the African man, and it is something great and it is something amazing, when you hear about the King Tuts, and when you hear about the Haitian warriors, and when you hear about the brown people all across the nation that literally started math, started arithmetic, started the seven liberal arts, gave Plato his name, gave Aristotle his name. Plato, Aristotle, they all went to school in Egypt. When you hear them trying to mislead you about the history of Egypt, understand that that's your history. Take that in. And if someone wants to tell you it's not, they're lying. They're not studying science. They're not studying anthropology. They're not studying facts. But if you yourself are having a hard time believing the beautiful things about you, take a look in the mirror. Tell yourself you're beautiful. Tell yourself that you're African, of African descent, and that all those things are true about you. And it's okay as an African person to know that you are strong, powerful, beautiful, not only deserve to be here, but you are the beginning and the end, and that means something. Take that in. I love you guys. I'm glad that I'm back here today talking to you. Have a wonderful, wonderful weekend.